Welcome to the Defense and Aerospace Report. I'm Vago Muradian here at the European Union's delegation to the United States to talk once again to Lieutenant General Esa Pulkkinen, who is the Director General of the European Union Military Staff. Sir, thanks very much. You were kind enough to meet with us earlier today with Jan Brooks, who is the NATO's International Staff Chief. Talk to us a little bit about whether you accomplished everything you hoped to accomplish on this trip. To clarify what NATO-EU cooperation looks like, but also what the EU is trying to do with PESCO and some other mechanisms to improve European capabilities to then become a better NATO partner.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much for your question. And I would say that I at least now believe that mission is accomplished. What I was having in my mind prior I came here with Jan Brooks, I think we have exceeded our expectations. So our messages on how to EU and NATO in military level work hand in hand was extremely well received, and that was our key message. So no competition, complementarity, and a lot of trust between the two military leaders of the EU and NATO and respective staff, of course. That's really key takeaway. And I think we managed to also provide clarity on certain issues that are being not so clear, misunderstood or misperceptions. Hopefully, I do hope so, but this is something that we need to continue. This is not a one-time shot, but I feel important to come again there to Washington to talk these issues. On PESCO, I would say that the key message that on PESCO, we are not trying to build up an European army or something like that, but all what comes out for the PESCO, it supports the NATO, and it supports NATO to an extent possible. I would say that no competition, stronger alliance through PESCO is one of the aims as well.
Talk to us a little bit about Brexit. That's a question. I have two questions about sort of pan-European cooperation and sort of the stealth state and the health of the European Union. Britain is leaving. You have a lot of highly qualified. When you and I have spoken in the past, you know, you've said like, wow, I mean, it's very talented people. Talk to us about how that process is going to work on the EU military side of things, and what are the implications, given that there are so many British staff officers across the EU, just like they are across NATO?
Yeah, like I said, I may have used the expression "I'm bleeding" when I talk about the Brexit, and it's indeed a reality in a couple of months, and unfortunately, I'm going to lose my British staff. Well, that's one point. Secondly, the UK's contribution for the EU military operation, CSDP operation, overseas operation, may have a break because we need to find out the status and have agreements present. We need the UK's contribution to missions and operation on the EU side for sure. On capability side, like we discussed, we are heavily dependent on UK capabilities. Capabilities, and hopefully they will be a solution that will allow UK to continue its contribution for the provision of capabilities for EU purposes as well. I think that I sense also from the messages I hear from London.
Do you feel the EU is under an enormous amount of pressure across the board? Angela Merkel is stepping down in a scenario that I think many people, if you'd gone back 5 years from now and said that the CDU and the CSU, as well as the SDB, would both be forced from power and it would be in the hands of Green and ADF and other parties. We've seen pressures in Poland, in Hungary. The Italian government is saying we're going to stay in the Eurozone, but still there is a very powerful anti-EU sentiment there. What are some of the, I mean, is this creating any challenges for you at the military staff level, given that, you know, it's a critical alliance with so many nations, but at the end of the day, there is a lot of backlash that's being pointed toward Brussels?
Yeah, I know precisely what you mean. So far, no big challenges from the military, but of course, I have concerns as any European on the fragmentation of the European Union. And we all know what is the legacy of the Second World War. I mean, and that was the foundation to establishment of the NATO and EU respectively. And I do hope that both institutions will continue. It's good for Europe and it was good for the United States.
And one last transatlantic rift question. You know, there are some people who did perceive they look at the rhetoric that comes out of Washington sometimes as, you know, America first, or conditional, Europeans spend more money and then we will give you protection. And then there are some who look at comments that Angela Merkel has made and Emmanuel Macron has made and said, you know, that both of the sides are drifting apart. From your standpoint, as an officer who has tremendous relationships here, but also are working at the EU and NATO level as well, even though Finland's not a NATO country, do you see kind of a splitting apart, or do you see that the foundations of the alliances are strong?
I think the foundation of the alliance is very strong. And of course, it's always some thunderstorms or storms at the political level. It's a democratic way to deal the issues. Political masters have their views and promoting their interests, but I think the foundation of the transatlantic link is so strong, and it will not be threatened by the current political environment.
And let me ask you one last question about EII. I know there are so many European acronyms, but Emmanuel Macron has talked about the European Intervention Initiative. Well, how does that fit in with everything that's going on right now?
Of course, we don't yet know actually what this political initiative will bring with. But I think that it can support the European NATO efforts as well in terms of the materializing certain permanent structural cooperation, PESCO projects, and also in operational terms to providing some element we could complement the current operational engagement through my training missions in Africa.
Finnish Lieutenant General Esa Pulkkinen, the Director General of the European Union Military Staff. Sir, thanks very, very much. It was an absolute pleasure talking to you twice in one day. It was a real honor. Thank you.
It's an honor for me to be here, my friend. Thanks.